sincerest sympathy for the Lucero family. This is a terrible, terrible tragedy. We all recognize that. But we must look forward to the future and how we are going to improve our sensitivity and understanding of student needs and the needs of the community. It's important for us to work together to overcome anything that could generate this type of hostility and intolerance of others that could lead young men to perpetrate this terrible, terrible crime on an innocent citizen of our community. We've done a lot of things in the last 5 years to work towards improving relationships and educational opportunities for students. Just this September, we began a dual language program in English and Spanish at Medford Elementary School in our kindergarten. This program is to grow each year until every grade level has a dual language program. And what that is that the class is divided evenly between Latino students and Anglo students. It's on a voluntary basis. In fact, we had so many people, families, interested in participating, we had to have a lottery to create this class. The students are taught in English one day and Spanish the next, all the students. And we believe that as we move this program to all of our elementary schools, because we are a school district in transition, in the last 5 years, we've gone from 4% to 24% Latino surnames in our school district. We recognize that we have to have programs that meet the needs of all of our students. We've increased the number of Latino staff members, Latino administrators. But this is something that we have to do more about. We have to reach out to the families of the students who come to this country and make them feel comfortable to come to our schools. We have to make sure that the students feel comfortable and are being educated. We have to make sure that all of our students can deal with each other as human beings. We started today, and this morning actually, each of the grade levels in the high school is meeting in an assembly to talk about what happened and what we can do to make sure that this never happens again. We've worked with a bias group in Suffolk County so that we can have programs in all 11 of our school buildings, that we can start working with children from kindergarten up about tolerance and sensitivity to each other's needs. We believe that this is the wave of the future and what we must do if we're going to make the school district represent all of the students who attend here. There are 8,500 students in our district, and 1/4 of them are from Latino families. We want to make sure that they learn and that they feel welcome. And we must work together. We have to go forward. We certainly are going to ask the county and the state to help us. We're concerned as anyone with the cost of programs. We're worried about money that may be taken from us in the next month because of the difficulty with taxes being raised in Albany. But we must pursue at all costs bringing our community together and our students so that they understand each other and that we have peace in our schools. Thank you very much.